Hola, hola. My name is Ramon, cosmetic formulator and sunscreen fanatic, and today we're talking about just that. I have a handful of American drugstore sunscreens, specifically from Neutrogena and Garnier, that launched within this last year. It took me a while to get my hands on them just because they're not available here in the UK, but thanks to my boyfriend, I have the full collection of the Invisible Defense line from Neutrogena, as well as the Garnier Green Lab 3-in-1 Serum sunscreens as well. Thank you guys for recommending these because I've been playing around with them for the last month or so, and very interesting experience. A few notes before we start. I did purchase all the Neutrogena sunscreens, or my boyfriend did anyways, and he also bought me one of the Garnier sunscreens, and then Garnier also sent them in PR as well, so I did get the full collection from Garnier. Opinions are my own. For the application footage you're going to see, you're going to see me apply 0.8 grams of the product on my face. That's how much sunscreen that I need for my face size. I calculated it. I have the video up here explaining how I did it if you want to figure out how much sunscreen that you need for your face. That was the sunscreen I applied to my face, worked it in, let it set in for at least 5 minutes before I went on top of it with makeup, and then because these are all chemical sunscreens, I also did reapply them on top of makeup to see how they reapplied, if they could reapply on top of makeup, and how that worked out. So that's the footage you're going to see. And I will also have timestamps for each individual sunscreen as well. So starting with the Neutrogena Invisible Defense line, I have three products in front of me. I have the Invisible Daily Defense Lotion. I think this is for face, but they also don't specify it, so this might be for the body. I also have the Invisible Daily Defense Face Serum. This is the one I was most excited for. And then the Invisible Daily Defense Face Mists, also one I was really excited for. And really what's interesting with this line is that they're really touting A, being very hydrating and lightweight, non-greasy, but moisturizing on the skin, and also really promoting the antioxidant benefits of these products. All of the Invisible Defense products have tocopherol, as well as feverfew extract, which is just a botanical extract that also amplifies some of the antioxidant benefits you're getting from the sunscreen. These are all water resistant. They're non-greasy, non-comedogenic, and they also all specify that they want to enhance radiance of the skin. Again, these are American, so they have the FDA approved filters only. They specify oxybenzone free, as well as some other things that kind of get into that clean beauty language I don't necessarily agree with, and I say that a lot on my channel. But aside from that, they're also touting the Helioplex complex, which is a Neutrogena patent around photostabilizing UV filters, just to ensure you're getting really good protection and that your filters aren't degrading upon UV exposure. I'm gonna start off with the lotion first. This is SPF 60+, broad spectrum. There's glycerin, which is the humectant. This one does also feature coloring. It has yellow 5 and red 40. So there is a color to it, and you can see it when I apply it on screen. This one also does have fragrance and alcohol. When it comes out of the tube, it has this like peachy color, but it's a very lightweight texture, very much a gel. It's very in line with, if you've used the products from the line, their Hydro Boost line. It's a very gel cream texture. I attribute it more to it being a sunscreen, but also being water resistant. There's an emollience to it that it's very lightweight, but it's very rich in emollience. And you see it when you apply it on the face. It's super lightweight and melting right away, but there's a sheen, there's body to it. And that's where, to me, it has a moisturizing quality to it. This is something that actually, for me as an oily skin individual, I want to use this by itself with no moisturizer, even though it is so lightweight and thin, because that emollience to me is actually kind of rich. You can see I apply on my skin. It looks great. I do have a radiance to my skin. This is spicy around the eye area, and I don't have sensitive eyes, first and foremost. So I felt it a little bit here around my orbital bone, and then with all of these, at some point, they dig into my eye, whether it was actual washing them off or the sunscreen itself just ran into my eye. So do note that. Sensitive eyes, don't recommend necessarily. Sensitive skin, don't recommend necessarily. Makeup applies beautifully on top of this, though. It does have that emollient that lends itself to prepping the skin nicely for makeup, but it's also very, very lightweight. Doesn't affect makeup application at all. I find that this just might have made my makeup a little bit more shiny, a little bit more soon. With the reapplication, it works okay. It just leaves your makeup very radiant. And that goes back to, it's just a very emollient sunscreen. There's nothing matte about this. It says it in the marketing. It's intended to like enhance skin's radiance. Fragrance for this, it's not overwhelming. It smells like cantaloupe to me. And to me, it does dissipate. But just note, has alcohol, has fragrance, will potentially irritate the eye area. And now getting onto the actual face sunscreen, this is the Invisible Daily Defense Face Serum, SPF 60+, broad spectrum. This one is technically fragrance-free. There's no fragrance compounds in this, but it does have ginger root extract, and I find that does lend itself to a bit of a sensory experience. It does still smell. I'm not gonna deny that it smells. It doesn't have actual fragrance. I don't know if it's the fact that it is ginger, and if you've ever eaten ginger, you know. There's a spice to it. There's a kick to it. This actually does sting my eyes. It's very rare that a sunscreen, to me, has like these red flags around the eye area. The lotion kind of irritated, and when I washed my face, it got into my eye and stung. This just on application got into my eye and stung. As soon as this goes on my face, I set it with powder, and that automatically mitigates any of those issues. I'm not saying it's going to be sensitive skin friendly though. Texture of this though is amazing, and that's why I'm like, I wish it was a like less irritating product. This is honestly the best option for oily skin, and it's a really good option for reapplication. You can see when I apply it to my face, this is a pump. I think this was 4 pumps exactly measured out to roughly 0.8 grams. That's enough for my face. I worked it in, melting beautifully. There's still some radiance to it, but to me it had a more lightweight texture, a little bit less of that emollience. Because this is a face sunscreen, I think they wanted to make it a little bit more elegant. Makeup applies great on top, and then with the reapplication, there's still some radiance to it, but if you like wait a bit, let it sit down, it's not horrible. It's just more of like a natural skin do. Go in with the powder, just lightly tap where you want to reduce shine, blot a little bit of powder in there, and your face is great for the day. Like, there's no issue. 4 pumps again is enough for my face. I actually went in with 6 pumps for my face though for reapp, just to see, and again it was fine. People are always concerned like, oh, the cushion puff might absorb product, so I was like, let me go a little bit extra and see. Totally fine, nothing weird, no texture issues. Makeup wears really nicely on this. The issue is just the eye irritation. You have to work around that. And then the mists. So I'm really interested in mists right now. Mists are like really hot. You're playing around with, can they be good initial application options if used the right way? And again, I explained, this is one that they instruct. Spray into your hands, massage into your face. And I did that for the initial application, but I was also like, can this work for reapplication and be like a nice elegant option? Because this is a big size and it says mist. You see some sprays sometime and you think, oh, it's going to mist. But no, when it says just spray, sometimes it just squirts out spurts of sunscreen, and it's not a good option for like face reapplication. It's SPF 50 only, not SPF 60 plus like the other two options. There's no humectants to this. It does have fragrance, and it's a different alcohol in this, but it does have alcohol because with this, you want it to be volatile enough that you spray it on the face. The alcohol evaporates out, so it sets a lot quicker to make it a more like elegant, lightweight experience. As I mentioned, I weigh my sunscreen when I'm like testing out new ones, just to note and be able to visualize what 0.8 grams for my face size looks like, just because sunscreens have different densities, so that amounts can vary in terms of how much space it takes up. So I use my scale. I used like a little dish. I have this little ramekin, and I just spritzed up in there till I got 0.8 grams. I did it a few times and I averaged that amount, and it was roughly about 7 spritzes for my face. And so what I did, 3 or 4 spritzes the first time, massaged it into my face, another 3 or 4 to equal to 7, massage that in, and I was good. To me, it's really odd because this is a spray. It's intended to be lightweight. There is body to it, similar to the lotion. There's a richer emollience than I would like out of the product. And so it's moisturizing, but it's actually kind of too rich for my oily skin, but it's not horrible. It's just like, oh, it's not what I was anticipating. With makeup application, again, it's emollient. It preps the skin nicely for makeup. What I really enjoyed about this, and like one of my like Ramon things, is I like a really, really radiant, but not greasy and oily base underneath matte makeup, because as the day kind of progresses and if you maintain it well, what happens is you get a really nice glow from within look that looks very natural when your makeup sits on your skin very, very nicely. Loved it. And so no issues with that. And again, it's a spray. It's a very, very lightweight, thin texture on the skin. So it's not heavy and it's not unbearable, but there is an emollience that I'm not a big fan of. But with reapplication, so that 7 spritzes, I was like, okay, just let me spritz this on my face. I don't find that this is a very fine mist. And I've been trying some other mists. Stay tuned. I have a whole video coming on about face mists and other reapplication methods. This is not a really fine mist. Again, it doesn't squirt out and just like spit it out at you, but it's not the finest. And that emollience really just sits on the face. You're not really able to massage it in. And I don't want to spray that on my face and go in with like a puff or a sponge and try to like pat it in. I think I did though, and it wasn't horrible. But with that, I'm like, I feel with that, you're blotting the coverage away. It was disappointing in the reapplication area. Don't recommend. So honestly, I'm not mad at these for initial application. But low key, if I had a choice and like I needed to, the serum would be the better reapplication. It just gets spicy around the eye area. And the last one, Neutrogena sunscreens, and separate of the Invisible Defense lines, the Hydro Boost. This has been around for a minute. She's not new. She's not anything innovative necessarily, but this is one I've actually used for a long time. I'm familiar with this. I just never talked about it on my channel for some reason. This is a chemical sunscreen, SPF 50, broad spectrum. This is intended to be a little bit more for oily skin types. This does have alcohol, this does have fragrance, and this does also have dye. One thing I don't understand, there's a lot of the Hydro Boost line specifically intended for sensitive skin types that is fragrance free, doesn't have dye. They don't have a sunscreen to go with it. And I feel like that would be a game changer if they did, but that's just me. This is 88 mil and I have the price on screen. It's not actually a bad price point for how much product you're getting. And this one does have oxybenzone. I've had this for a minute now. I don't know if they have an oxybenzone free version, but just note that. And then this one is 80 minutes water resistant, which for the texture would never have guessed. There's not a lot much going on besides a lot of humectants. Again, this is a very elegant gel texture. This comes out, this melts into the skin. Super elegant, very lightweight, sinks in within minutes, and you honestly can't tell. aside from a slightly radiant finish. It looks very fresh. It's not heavy at all. Has none of the emollients you feel with the Invisible Defense Lotion. So worth noting, I prefer this texture a lot more. This burns your eyes like nobody's business. And that is my one caveat and something I've thought every time I've ever used this. It stings my eye area. It gets into my eyes easily. It burns my eyes. So this is one option where once I put it on my skin, I need to set this around my eye area with a powder. That being said, because it is a nice texture, it sinks in right away, super lightweight, makeup goes beautifully on top of this, and this reapplies really nicely on top of makeup. I just tend to avoid my eye area, or I'm a little bit more meticulous to not get so close to my actual eyelid, the mobile lid, where like the product will transfer and then run into the eye. I kind of stick more towards right on the brow bone, right on the orbital bone. I love what this product could have been and what it could be. I just need Neutrogena to come out with a fragrance-free, dye-free. I don't mind the alcohol, I actually prefer that, but just the fragrance issue and like it just stinks so bad around the eyes. That's my one caveat. Next, let's get into from the Green Labs line. I guess that's their like approach to like more natural products or more clean products. I don't know. What they are intending these to be is three products in one. You have a serum. Each of them has a specific active benefit for the skin. A moisturizer, which technically all sunscreens are essentially moisturizers with UV filters in them, but it's just saying that like you can use this in place of a moisturizer, which I always do when always recommend for oily skin. And then you also have the sunscreen benefit to them. So if you are someone like me, less is more. You want as few layers as possible with as many benefits as you can get. Wash your face or just rinse your face off in the morning. Put one of these on. Make sure you put enough on to get the adequate protection. You're out the door and you're good. There's three of these. So I was really putting these to the test to really see how they compared to each other. There are very subtle differences, but that actually could really influence how you choose to pick which one you want to use. Also worth noting, these are actually, in my opinion, for the most part, very sensitive skin friendly. I had no irritation on my skin, and I'm having a little bit more of a compromised skin issue right now. So starting with the oily skin specific option, I have their Cannabis, which I also know in some markets this is marketed as niacinamide, just because the canna obviously is cannabis sativa, includes niacinamide, and then the cannabis sativa oil. It's supposed to be non-greasy while also simultaneously helping to refine pore and texture issues, helps to even out skin pigmentation issues, and helps to balance the skin slash regulate sebum production. It also can have some antioxidant benefits as well. You also got caprolactone salicylic acid, which is like the PHA version of salicylic acid, a more gentle variation of it. What it does in the formulation, I don't know, because it's technically actually in all of these and it doesn't mention any exfoliating benefits. I don't know if it's giving more humectant benefits or some formulation preservation potential. I'm not entirely sure. Alcohol, fragrance, and essential oil free as well. I think all of them are alcohol free. Some of them do have fragrance. With these, all of them, 4 pumps is enough for my face. So you see me apply those 4 pumps. This is really nice. This is creamy. This does leave me with a very natural finish though. It does control my oil throughout the day, but it doesn't leave me matte. And that's something I want to know. It doesn't make you matte at all. This is oily skin friendly. It does keep me from getting like real oily. Definitely a little bit more creamy, but it's not emollient. It's not greasy, even though it does have that cannabis sativa oil. If I could compare this to any product, and I'm going to also reference this in terms of the fragrance as well, it reminds me a lot of the Great Barrier Relief from Crave Beauty in the texture, the feel, the finish on the skin, and the smell. It smells very oaty to me. There's no oat in this, but it has like an oat smell. Makeup goes on top beautifully, no issues at all there. And this reapplies the best on top of makeup out of all of these, I think. This is definitely a really good option. Something I would definitely consider a year-round option because it's moisturizing, it's oil controlling, but it's not matte, and it leaves the skin very nicely like fresh looking. So definitely a great option if you have oily skin, especially if you don't want to be matte. Next, let's get into their Hyalumelon, and this is supposed to be really, really hydrating. Watermelon and hyaluronic acid, which work to improve dehydrated skin and the appearance of fine lines so that your skin looks bouncier and smoother. It claims skin looks instantly smoother and more elastic in 3 days. Fine lines look reduced over time. And to me, this is just really enhancing the benefits of topically, like visually, if you just infuse hydration to the skin, your skin's going to look more plump. It's not going to erase your wrinkles, but it's just going to infuse hydration to your skin, improves the appearance of making your skin look more plump. It's not a miracle product. But this gives me like Glow Recipe teas, and obviously the watermelon's a big indicator of that. With watermelon, it has watermelon fruit extract, which gives antioxidant benefits. And then you also have glycerin and sodium hyaluronate to really compound those hydrating benefits as well. This is alcohol free, but this does have that like watermelon Jolly Rancher Glow Recipe signature smell to it. This one was nice and lightweight. I definitely get the fact that it is juicy and hydrating. It's actually a little bit more lightweight than the Cannabis one. One of the things that's most in common as well with the Glow Recipe product that I think was more of a con was it left your skin kind of tacky, which I love for makeup. Makeup just sticks on, makeup looks great. Because this is a little bit more thin of a consistency and more lightweight, this smells into the skin beautifully, as you can see. I feel like makeup really went well on top of this and looked great. I had no issues with that. But with reapplication, that's where that negative aspect really came out, because the moment I took that cushion puff and went to apply the sunscreen on my face on top of the makeup, that tackiness just lifted the makeup off. So not a great option for reapplication over makeup, even though it is really lightweight. And I do think it's a great option for just reapplication on bare skin. It's lightweight, it's juicy, it's hydrating, it's really refreshing actually on the skin. I have dehydrated skin. I don't mind a radiant appearance. Then the last one we're gonna talk about is their, I don't know if it's Pineacy or Pineacy, but this is their Skin Brightening 3-in-1 sunscreen product. It's for dull and uneven skin. So if you have pigment issues or issues around discoloration, and it has pineapple and vitamin C benefits, which work to improve dull, uneven skin for skin that is brighter and more even in appearance. It helps to improve the overall glow and healthy look of the skin in a few days, and dark spots will fade over time. And what that's attributed to is it has ascorbyl glucoside, which is a vitamin C derivative that's actually really nice. It's not a bad one. And you also have pineapple fruit extract, as well as papain. And so papain is a component of pineapple extract. That is the enzymatic exfoliating property of it. So just note that it does have that benefit to it. There's no indication of that because it's not really sensitizing on the skin. But pineapple fruit extract, because it's a natural extract, is more complex as well. So beyond just those mild exfoliating benefits from the enzymatic properties, you also do have antioxidant benefits, a lot of vitamins, some nice soothing and moisturizing properties as well. This is fragrance, so you have like a nice tropical smell to it. It's nice and pleasant and not too overpowering, so do note that. But this does also have phenylethyl resorcinol, which is also a really great antioxidant ingredient. This one, again, similar to the Hyalumelin, super lightweight actually, sinks into the skin right away. Not tacky though, which I prefer a lot more. And it looks really good on the skin. This is actually what I have right now underneath my makeup. I think arguably this is my number two favorite, right behind the Canon B one. And honestly, they're actually more neck and neck, just because each of them has a quality I like more, but each of them also has qualities I wish the other one had. So it's just kind of like time and place situation. This is more lightweight again. It's a little bit more dewy radiance as opposed to the Canon B, which is a little bit more matte. It's not as tacky and it's not as sticky as the Hyalumelin, so that's why I think it's a little bit better of an option. The benefits overall, this is my favorite out of the 3-in-1s, because brightening benefits, antioxidant benefits, sunscreen benefits, it's hydrating, it's not too heavy, so I think that's why it's also like more neck and neck with the Canopy. So with that, that's my opinion of the new launches from Neutrogena and Garnier. I say new because, again, I haven't had these when they first launched, and I've been testing them out for a couple months, and so at this point they're kind of older news, but they came out this year and that's what matters. Links for these are going to be down in the description box, so make sure you check those out if you want to get your hands on these. Let me know down below, have you tried any of these, what your thoughts and experiences were on them? Tell me what some of your other favorite American drugstore sunscreens are as well. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, hit that subscribe button, notification bell, so that you know when I post more skincare, sunscreen, and fancy related content on my channel. Thanks for watching, guys. Bye.